Welcome, everyone, to meeting number 211 of the Planning Committee. This meeting is being broadcast on the internet, and the recording of this meeting will be published on the Council's website. Given the COVID-19 circumstances, we can't have members of the community here with us in the gallery, but it's terrific that we can still share our meetings with you via the live stream. Council also acknowledges the Wadawurrung traditional owners of this land, and I pay my respects to all elders, past and present, and to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people who are part of the Greater Geelong community today. I'll introduce the panel that we have with us today. We have Councillor Murray, Councillor Mansfield, Councillor Harwood, Councillor Mason, Councillor Murnane, and I'm Councillor Sullivan. From the officers, we have Joanne Van Slagren, Manager, City Development, John Rush, Coordinator, Statutory Planning, and Rory O'Loughlin, Team Leader, Statutory Planning. Objectors and applicants were able to lodge a submission prior to this meeting, close of business Wednesday of last week, replacing the past personal presentations. Objector and applicant submissions were provided to this committee on Thursday of last week. The procedure for the hearing items this evening will be: the officers will present a brief summary of the written report to the committee. The panel may then ask questions of the officer. The panel will then further discuss the application and make a decision. The decision of this committee is the final decision of the council acting under delegated authority. If anyone is aggrieved by the decision of this committee, they may appeal to the Victorian Civil Administrative Tribunal in Melbourne. Our staff can assist with this process during office hours. Now, I'll confirm the minutes of the last meeting, which was dated 27th of August, 2020. Can we have a mover, Councillor Murnane? Thank you, you were there. And I think the other councillor there was Councillor Harwood for seconder. Thank you very much. And we have no declarations of interest. None to be noted. The matter for consideration today is item PP-276-2016 /C, 7-9 Ballarat Road, North Geelong. 12 submissions and one written objection were received by this planning committee, that being from Mr. Rob Nissen of North Geelong, and his concerns relate to timing to implement landscaping plans, no remedy for the shipping container on site, the large concrete wall, noise, gate access, and significant loss of amenity and living standards. The applicant's response notes, there have been no noise complaints since the club commenced their operations. The club has tested the PA system to ensure it will comply. External PAs to be used only in emergencies. The gate on the east side remains a pedestrian gate and is not available for normal access by any person as per the Section 173 agreement on title. The club have made changes to the lighting numerous times as a result of the complaint from one of the neighbours. In doing so, the club believes there is no unreasonable lighting extending beyond the site. The request for increased morning operational hours is for breakfast meetings or bowls to commence early only, and in regard to increased evening hours, it is not an attempt to create a quasi-hotel operation, it is a desire to operate with greater flexibility to meet the needs of the users. That was a response from the applicant. I will now hand over to officers to present a brief summary of the report to the committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Sullivan. It's Rory O'Loughlin speaking. Just a brief comment on your comments. Just that the third party appeal, there's no third party appeal rights available to objectors owing to the development plan overlay. So just a point of clarification there. To speak about the application before the committee, it relates to the Geelong Bowls Club at 7-9 Ballarat Road in North Geelong. The current use and development of the land is regulated by planning permit number PP276 of 2016, and that permit allows bowls to be played and the club room to be open between 10 a.m. and 10 p.m. 7 days a week. It's proposed to amend that permit by increasing the hours bowling is permitted, beginning at 7 a.m. each day and continuing through to 10 p.m. Monday through Wednesday and on Sunday nights. So in terms of the closing hours, that's no change to what's permitted at the moment. Proposed to finish playing bowls at 11 p.m. on Thursday nights and finishing at midnight on Friday and Saturday evenings. It's proposed to increase the hours the club rooms could be used, beginning at 7 a.m. each day and continuing until 11 p.m. Monday through Thursday and on Sunday nights, and continuing till midnight on Friday and until 1 a.m. on Saturday and Sunday mornings. No change is sought to the time that liquor can be consumed in the morning, that is a 10 a.m. start, and extensions to licensed hours are proposed to be consistent with the closing hours of the club room. It's worth noting that the consumption of liquor on the greens is required to cease by 8 p.m. Amendments to the landscape plan are also sought, and in summary, when compared to the currently approved landscaping, there would be less trees planted in the car park, less trees at the northern end of the existing greens, and the landscaped crib wall that faces the fairway would be changed to wire mesh attached to the existing concrete retaining wall, and then plants would then be planted and encouraged to climb up the mesh. The land is within a special use zone, SUZ3, and affected by a development plan overlay, DP09, and special building overlay. This application, as I was talking about before, was exempt from the advertising provisions of the Planning and Environment Act, and also is exempt from the normal rights of review that objectors have. Even so, letters were sent to the residents of the Fairway, Park Court and Birdie Court seeking their feedback on the proposed amendments. 12 submissions were received, and they raised matters such as amenity to do with noise, patron behaviour and the like, that the use seeks to cater for non-bowls related activities, matters to do with the gate on the Fairway, issues concerning proposed landscaping and existing non-compliance with the permit. It's understood one of the submitters has taken the opportunity to provide a further submission to the committee, as you just said, Councillor. It's recommended to support some, but not all, of the proposed amendments. The exact recommendation is detailed in the officer's report, but broadly speaking, the earlier operating hours are supported. The later operating hours are not supported, except for an additional hour for the club room to be open on weekends, that is to close at 11 p.m. on Friday and Saturday night. And bowling is not recommended to extend beyond 10 p.m. as is currently the case. Changes to landscaping are supported, and additional planting is recommended at the northern end of the land where a third green was approved but has not been constructed. Other conditions are also recommended. These are to close doors and windows after 10 p.m, to install a noise limiter, and to do some testing on the outdoor lighting. I'm happy to take questions from the committee.
Thank you, Mr. Loughlin, and apologies for my misinformation earlier.
That's okay.
Questions from the panel so far? Councillor, please.
Thank you, Councillor Sullivan. Rory, could you please clarify can you add to, I heard it was stated that there was no complaints about noise. Can you speak to that, please?
Certainly, we had submissions, and there have been 12 submissions during the application process. Prior to that, there have been some complaints raised with the with council officers, mainly to do with lights. There's some and also to do with noise, the banging of a flagpole, and some issues to do with the loudspeaker. So there've been some complaints outside of the planning process that we've just been through.
So you're not aware of unruly behaviour late at night?
The first that I heard of that was in a submission, sorry.
Under the current circumstances?
Only what's in the submissions raised during this process in terms of unruly behaviour.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Mason. Any other questions or queries from the panel? No, no further questions of officers? Well, fantastic. Nice to see the process. Thank you very much, Ms. Orban.
Thank you.
Given there's no more queries or statements to be made, do I have a recommendation from the panel to be moved?
Mr. Chairman, I have an alternative recommendation.
Please. Do we have a seconder for Councillor Murray's alternate recommendation? Councillor Murray?
Yes, thank you. And that the alternative recommendation is, without going through all the conditions, I will take it straight to item 10. And it's what Rory was talking about, the hours of operation. And the alternative recommendation is that the bowling greens must only be used between the hours of 7 a.m. and 11 p.m. to the satisfaction of the responsible authority. And in relation to the club rooms must only be used between the hours of 7 a.m. and 12 midnight to the satisfaction of the responsible authority. And the other conditions in relation to landscaping are as recommended. And so there, the basis, that's the basis for the alternate recommendation, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Councillor Murray. Councillor Manane, do you wish to speak?
Thank you, Councillor Sullivan. I think the recommended changes by Councillor Murray here are very reasonable in the context of this particular facility. I think we need to take into account that the particular attributes of this facility are unique in the Geelong area, in as much as that it is, they're covered, and that they're providing a level of bowling that is not generally enjoyed across the region. If you go to some other regional towns, I've been to the bowling club at Warrnambool, for example, who've just built a very similar one. And also there are a number up on the Murray. These particular facilities are highly sought after and do have an opportunity to actually bring bowlers into the area as well. That can lead to both competition bowling as well as social bowling. And often with the competition bowling, the events are slightly longer and may run over several days, and the actual facilities of the quality and size and length of term are often required to run these successful events. Notwithstanding, I think the social bowls for the local members themselves are enormously important as well. I also think that with respect to the older generation, we do have an increasing number of people in this bracket of society. Opportunities for exercise are enormously important for them. They do need to get due consideration of their rights and opportunities like everybody else in our community. And bowling is one of those options that many older people take up. I think what is proposed in terms of the criteria here is very reasonable, and especially when we consider the people who are likely to be using this facility for the great percentage of time. So I support Councillor Murray's recommendation and like to see it proceed. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Murnane. Councillor Harwood.
Thank you, Councillor Sullivan. I also support Councillor Murray, his alternate recommendation. I guess having experience with local bowling clubs in different manners, I find that the way they operate, what they provide for the community is invaluable. And looking at the particular hours of operation and the intent of the business down there, I'm fully supportive. And as has been alluded to, the capacity to hold big events that will be of significant value to the community, not just economically, but certainly socially. I fully support, and living very close to a large bowling facility, which has similar hours of operation, I've not experienced any reason why I would not support such an application to be consistent across our region. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Harwood. Any other panel members wish to speak before we move a recommendation? No worries. All right, well, I move Councillor Murray's alternate recommendation to the vote. All those in favour? All those against? The alternate recommendation is passed. Thank you. Well, thank you to everybody for watching at home. Thank you to my fellow panel members, and thank you for all the officers for joining us this evening as well. I'll call to a close the planning meeting number 211 of the Planning Committee at 2:17 p.m. Thank you.